Good afternoon. My name is Hans ten Bergen. In the next 15 minutes, I would like to explain to you how artificial intelligence is able to reduce the impact of disasters. If your region, your city, power plant or infrastructure would have been hit by the same disaster for the second time, would your responses be better, be more accurate and effective than when this happened the first time? If you had been put in the same position to manage a similar disaster before, would you now be able to reduce the impact of this disaster to your region, to your city or to your power plants? If you have been able to see the impact of your decisions on the evacuation of people from affected areas, if you have experienced the real timing of evacuating large groups of people, healthy, both healthy and injured, if you have put the real capacity of hospitals to the test, and what about the same for operating rooms and safe areas, would you be able to save lives? The answer to these questions is probably yes, because you learn from earlier experiences, lessons learned, as they say. Fortunately, these lessons can be learned without having to go through all the misery, grief, and devastation of a real disaster. Today, most of disaster management preparation is done through board games, tabletop exercises, role plays, and through the writing of emergency plans. This is not bad, but there's a lot of guessing involved and a lot of assumptions. It is more or less all right for straightforward incidents, but not by far to calculate the impact of complex disaster scenarios. The people in the crisis cell getting trained are not put in a crisis situation that's giving a realistic representation of the disaster. They're not using the same means of communication as they would be using during a real disaster. And the training environment does not interact with the decisions taken and does not give them a dynamic feedback. Simulation, using a visualization, using realistic visualization, can solve these problems. The values we are therefore going to add are realism and accuracy. MASA Synergy is an artificial intelligence management simulation platform that is able to do this. It will also allow you to improve the communication between all the agencies and actors involved in a very cost-effective way. Now, with MASA Synergy, the people in the crisis cell can learn how to deal with the disaster or a crisis by putting them in a situation that exactly matches the reality of the disaster. This means that they're sitting in the same room as during a real crisis. They're using the exact same means of communication as during a real disaster. And they will be looking at the same images as they are looking at during the real situation. No difference for them. This is shown on the right-hand side, on the right-hand side of this slide. The real difference starts outside their range of vision, which is shown on the left-hand side of the slide. The trainees are giving their instructions to the subordinate level, as usual. The subordinate level, however, is being replaced by a facilitator who translates these instructions into actions and activities within the simulation. The system then automatically decomposes these high-level instructions into actions and activities at every subordinate level, and artificial intelligence then determines the impact on the situation and how it progresses. Operational reports from the incident area will then be sent back up through all the levels of the incident organization, resulting in a new status report at the facilitator level. The facilitator in turn communicates a new position to the trainees and their team. As a result, MASA Synergy is replacing the propagation of the disaster, the impact on people and the infrastructure, and it is replacing the actors involved, both the victims and the emergency responders and their material. Hence, there is a dynamic interaction between the instructions given and a continuously evolving situation and environment. But what does it look like, this of artificial intelligence simulation? Bear in mind that we are training people like mayors, senior crisis staff, and plan managers. That theater, therefore, is a map, because the people in the crisis cell need to deal with the bigger picture of the disaster. The impact of an earthquake does not remain limited to a single city or region. It can have an impact on an entire country, or even across borders. We are therefore not representing individuals or single vehicles, but aggregated units. The decision makers are not interested in a flat tire of a fire engine, but in the availability of an entire team. The units are represented on the map by recognizable symbols. And as I mentioned before, the units act autonomously, constantly providing updates about their status and the results. But there are much more use cases, more applications of the use of artificial intelligence than only training the decision makers. I will mention you some. Let's start with disaster management plan validation. These plans may contain, as you know, a high level of we assume, we suppose, we think, and we guess even. And it's true, it's very difficult to test, to validate these assumptions in real life. Mazda Synergy, however, offers the possibility to process all these assumptions through the artificial intelligence engine, resulting in a reliable and validated emergency or disaster plan. You can also make what-if analysis, trying out alternative response strategies for the same incident. Yet another use case is support for preparation of large-scale live exercises. Large-scale live exercises are very costly because of the high number of resources and vehicles involved. Some of these resources only participate to allow the higher level commanders and crisis staff to play the role well. The artificial intelligence can replace a part of these resources and vehicles, thus dramatically reducing the costs of a live exercise. The last use case I would like to mention is decision support. In contrast to the other use cases, to the other applications, this is an operational application. During a real crisis, all the details of the events and the deployment of resources are registered in an emergency response system or a command and control system. All these elements can be fed into Mazda Synergy. And since our artificial intelligence is able to calculate, to process much faster than the human brain, several alternative response strategies can be calculated by the system in a matter of seconds. As a result of these calculations, the artificial intelligence will come up with the outcome of these alternatives. The best one can be picked and executed, in this case, alternative number two. In the remaining minutes, I'm going to show you what Mazda Synergy looks like. The first example is a flooding scenario in Paris, and the second one, a volcanic outburst on the island, the Caribbean island of Guadeloupe. The last major flooding in Paris was in 1910, and statistically, this happens every 100 years. In order to be prepared, the agglomeration of Paris did two exercises with Mazda Synergy, one with the emergency services and one with the utilities companies, mobile telephone operators, radio and television broadcasting companies, hospitals, insurance companies, fuel companies, and the like. We are first going to have a look at the latter. Can you please start the video? What you see is the map of Greater Paris. The orange symbols are representing the base stations of one of the mobile telephone operators, and the blue symbols are representing the offices of an insurance company. The streaming dotted green lines represent the electricity grid. The blue meandering line is the River Seine, as you would have supposed. And as you can see, the water is slowly flooding the lower parts. This is not only a graphical representation, the water is an intelligent object which will really start to impact the infrastructure, as shown on the map, but also on the right-hand side on the scores. These scores, for instance, show the number of households being affected, the percentage of access to internet and communication, and the number of hospital beds available. You might also have noticed that the parts of the electricity net that have been affected have come to a halt. Can I have the next video, please? Thank you. The next example I'm going to show is a combination of an exercise and validation of the disaster plans for a volcanic outburst on Guadeloupe, an island in the Caribbean. What you're seeing here is an unplanned evacuation of a village close to the volcano after an unexpected earthquake, which is usually taking place prior to the outburst of the volcano. This is how an evacuation happens today. It takes over about 5 hours. The circles you see represent a number of people living in a particular part of town who are trying to get out to safer grounds. This is being represented by the moving lines. These crowds are moving autonomously. Taking into account the capacity of the road, the means of transportation they are using, and the others using the same road. And it looked very chaotic, and it is true, because it's very uncontrolled and it's not managed at all. It's just spontaneously. That is why we are now going to have a look at a more controlled evacuation with the emergency services involved. You're looking at the same situation, and on the right-hand side, you see a number of police cars hurrying to the affected area. And they are blocking the roads, and they're stopping the crowds who come from areas that have been impacted to a lesser extent than the ones closest to the volcano. As you can also see, a part of the crowds are now taking the western coast road instead of all taking the southern route. This controlled situation took about 2 hours, here shown in 45 seconds in a simulation, in this simulation. Finally, we are going to have a look at the rescue of victims who have stayed behind after the volcanic outburst. On the right-hand side, you see the view of the situation as it really is. The different colors represent the level of ashes. Again, these ashes are an intelligent object that will slow down the rescue of the people and the transportation by the ambulances. The emergency services will only learn about these conditions when they get there. That is why these ashes are not shown on the big map in the middle, in the center part. On the eastern part of the island, there's a medical command post where victims are triaged before they are being transported to the hospital, to the major hospital of the big city, of the only big city of the island. On the left-hand side, you see a graph representing the number of people being triaged and the result of the triage. I hope I have been able to show you how artificial intelligence can help to reducing the impact of disasters. Are there any questions? Thank you.